Okay,
you're on.
I guess I'm on. Well, I want to talk about a concept for a new global center that bridges the worlds of science and technology innovation and decision making, the Global Center for Emerging Technologies Intelligence, or SETI, not to be confused with the Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, which is another SETI. Now, more than I think any previous point in history, the world is depending on technology innovation. Global populations approaching 7 billion people, quality of life expectations higher than ever before, and an increasingly close relationship between what we do and the environment we live in. 21st century society will be unsustainable, I'm afraid, without major technological breakthroughs. At the same time, science and technology are advancing faster than ever before. Our generation has seen more technological change over a shorter period than any previous one, and the rate of tech innovation continues to grow. The trouble is, there's a disconnect between technology innovation and the challenges we hope to solve with it. We simply don't know the best way to tap into the potential of emerging science and technology. Part of the problem is that we face a monumental communication barrier. Decision makers believe in tech solutions, but assume that they will simply appear as and when they're needed. On the other hand, innovators believe they hold the keys to social and economic prosperity, but quite often they have little idea on how to put their ideas to good. The result is we have all the pieces to improve the world through tech innovation, but we lack the manual that tells us how to do it. And to make matters worse, old ways of matching tech innovation to prosperity don't work well in a fast-track world where traditional economic, social, and political boundaries are crumbling. So the proposed center, SETI, aims to provide at least pieces of this manual, enabling senior decision makers on a global scale to develop and use emerging technologies most effectively. If SETI's to work, it's going to depend on three things. It's going to depend on authority, encompassing technical authority, scientific authority, social, economic, and political expertise. In fact, that was the second point. It's also, as well as authority, it's got to deal with social, economic, and political expertise. But thirdly, and perhaps most importantly, it's got to have the support of senior decision makers in government and in business, and effective communication with stakeholders. There's a wealth of expertise around the world in tech innovation and decision-making, and we're already tapping into that, especially through the World Economic Forum Global Agenda Councils. Likewise with communication expertise, there's a lot of expertise available and we're already beginning to tap into that. But what is crucial here is buy-in from senior government and business leaders. These are the people who are responsible for making technology innovation work for society, who can identify the challenges that we're facing and who can act on intelligence and recommendations coming out of the center. SETI, if it's established, will provide for the first time a global 21st century perspective on 21st century challenges. Emerging technologies are often counterintuitive. They need new thinking on finding appropriate and workable solutions to challenges. Recent emerging technologies such as nanotechnology and biotechnology have shown us how hard it is to overcome hurdles to tech transfer, oversight, and public acceptance. These technologies have taught us, if nothing else, that innovative approaches are needed to take advantage of innovative solutions. As new technologies arise, such as things like synthetic biology, we've now got geoengineering on the map, robotics has obviously been bubbling along for a while, a new global perspective on challenges and solutions will be needed. I think the last thing we can afford is another GMO debacle. At the same time, we need to ensure promising technology innovations bloom and aren't crushed through a lack of foresight. So SETI directly addresses this need, and it will succeed precisely because it provides an elegant and workable solution to the challenges government and business leaders will increasingly be faced with over the coming years. So what do we need to make SETI work? Well, three things. First and foremost, we need buy-in from senior leaders in government and industry. These are the people who will drive the agenda and implement the outputs of the center. Second, we need to engage more thoroughly with thought leaders around the world. We already have good connections with many innovative thinkers, but for the center to work, these need to be great connections, covering the gamut of cutting-edge science to social policy. And third and finally, and perhaps not surprisingly, we need funding. Over the first 3 years, SETI will cost an estimated $20 million. So if you look out over the next 20 years, this will be a critical period for society around the globe. Emerging technologies clearly hold the key to sustained prosperity, but they won't just happen. SETI is a unique and vital opportunity to connect innovation to need and to ensure new technologies solve some of the most pressing challenges we face as a global society. Thank you.